My name is Peter Lamont. I was a production designer on License to Kill. And here we are in an amazing holiday home that belonged to the De Porta Novas, friends of Mr. and Mrs. Broccoli, in whose holiday home we shot. The house actually is called Arabesque. It's built on these three huge arches into the rock. This is Michael Ford on the left. My brother's on the right, and Tony Graysmark, who was our construction coordinator, in the centre. Michael Ford was my set decorator on a number of films. He's currently got two Oscars. He won one for Raiders of the Lost Ark, and then his second one came with me when we were on the sinking ship Titanic together. An amazing place. They had a paddle tennis court. There was even a nightclub down below, discotheque. There were a number of swimming pools all around this. The whole place was beyond belief. This place was so big that most of the seating, as you can see here, was built almost to heroic size because of the enormity of the whole building. The whole crew, I don't think could imagine the wealth of these people. It's kind of beyond belief. This is Bert Hearn and Tony Graysmark again, our construction coordinator. Here we are down on the beach, and it's just a sensational position. And we're just playing around here with one of the motorboats that we were going to use when Bond zips away from Arabesque. It's my wife and Michael Ford on the beach. Here we are in Arabesque. This was on the roof. It was all in white alabaster, and there's like a whole camel train in this white alabaster, with all these palm trees all potted, and then the whole complex was down below. The gentleman in the middle is Bert Hearn, who is our property master. Here's the waterfall that Ricky De Porta Nova built for his wife, who loved the sound of water. And this is done on an amazing scale. Everything was done. Tony Way there and Miss Broccoli. Now, I believe this could have been the private jet that brought Mr. and Mrs. Broccoli down. It belonged to Sir Gordon White, and he provided a jet for them to go down to Mexico, down to Acapulco. It was an amazing. This is the dining room. They could actually seat 60 people. They could provide decor for any season, any time, Easter, Christmas, New Year. And I remember saying to the manager, I said, I suppose they just come in or ad lib. He said, oh, no. He said, they have to give us at least 2 weeks' notice. This is my brother on the left, Bob Walker's on the right. And this is the approach to Churubusco Studios, where the whole film was based, and we shot the majority of our sets here. This is coming in the minibus that they used to pick us up every morning from our home, which was adjacent to the studio. Three of us lived together, my brother and his wife. Tony Graysmark and his wife and my wife and I lived in this house. It was a medieval looking house in corridores. It was about 10 minutes from the studio. We had bicycles, and this is the exterior of the house, where we're just on our way to work. Chuchu is our driver, and this is from the terrace of the house. It was supposed to be a medieval building, but we think it was built in probably about 1947. The reason why you can't see much, the electricity had been cut off because the lady who owned the house hadn't paid the bill. We paid her, she paid the bill. It was an amazing place, and glad we did it there. I have been back to Mexico City 3 times since to do other films. People there are great, construction crews, none better.